Everyone is asking this question. What's the difference between VPN and proxy? Aren't they just the same? Okay, at first glance, this is exactly the case when comparing VPN versus proxy. Both hide the IP address and can access foreign content, but that's only on the surface. VPN and proxy are widely different in terms of the connection you're getting. So, what is a VPN? A VPN is a tool that reroutes your connection through a secure VPN server and encrypts it in the process. In comparison, what is using a proxy meaning? A proxy also reroutes your connection through a mediation server, but applies no security in the process. So, yes, it might seem that they achieve the same result, and you might even think that they can be used together, but I don't recommend that. Running a VPN proxy combo is just going to reroute your connection twice, increasing the distance of connection and slowing down your speed and causing connection instability. It's just not worth it. And this is not speculation. Here are two very detailed examples of how top-tier VPN providers win where proxies fail. Starting with daily browsing, what is proxy server capable of in this scenario? Proxies allow you to become anonymous, whether you're gonna check a cooking guide or look up some questionable stuff online. That's because a proxy substitutes your IP address with its own, effectively hiding your digital identity online. Since an IP address is a digital address of your device, you don't want anybody knowing it. I'm using a VPN for the same reason, except that I'm getting a few extra benefits. Each VPN connection is safely encrypted, and providers like NordVPN or Surfshark use the latest encryption methods available right now, a major upside for security. If there are internet disruptions, both VPNs and proxies will most likely disconnect. But thanks to a kill switch, VPN providers won't reveal your IP address on disconnect, disabling your internet connection entirely instead. A proxy is not going to be able to do that. Of course, VPNs do have one unfortunate downside. Top providers are often paid, but don't worry, I've left some of the best VPN deals you can find in the description below. Continuing with the topic of secure browsing, proxies won't be able to get rid of trackers, ads, notifications, and other malware-ridden pop-ups. In comparison, NordVPN comes with threat protection, a feature I use every day to cleanse my browser from all those nasty pop-ups. Some other providers like TotalVPN even come with full-fledged antivirus and ad block solutions. I know you might be thinking, what's stopping a VPN from collecting my data by itself and then using it however it pleases? Well, for that purpose, providers like NordVPN, Surfshark, and ExpressVPN have RAM-only servers, which don't retain user data. They also comply with no logs policies, promising to not record any information from their users, and independent audits are used to ascertain the validity of those promises. So another significant downside of a VPN is that not all of them work reliably on all major operating systems. Conversely, top VPN providers usually have separate apps for all popular devices designed specifically for those. Compatibility is hardly an issue. My second VPN versus proxy example lies in streaming and gaming. Don't get me wrong, proxies are often used to access streaming content around the world, and they even work flawlessly, except when they don't. Yet that's the main issue, inconsistency. They're actually quite detectable by gaming and streaming services. So proxies are often disconnected, banned, or straight up throttled. So even the benefit of performance flies straight out the window. Hey, I'm not gonna pretend that all VPNs are good for streaming and gaming, though, and accessing geo-blocked content reliably requires a specific set of capabilities. I find Surfshark to be one of the most reliable VPN options in this case because it has a healthy amount of servers in 100 countries across the world. I managed to access the most content using Surfshark, including Indian streaming, which has been pretty hard to watch ever since legislation changed in the country. So if you're still set on streaming and gaming with a VPN, you need good performance. I have mentioned NordVPN as a speedy option, but Surfshark is actually just as decent. It runs a WireGuard protocol, and I had a very low ping when playing my favorite games, which is the most important thing. So whether you want to find bot lobbies in Warzone or play a game of Fortnite in a different country, Surfshark works like clockwork. Since I play with a lot of friends, I appreciate Surfshark's unlimited connections even more. So I'm sharing one account with a bunch of friends at this point so we can all hang out together. At the end of the day, the main VPN proxy difference lies in versatility. So VPNs are more well-rounded than proxies. They have better performance, more reliable security, and they provide access to way more content. So which one do you prefer, VPN or proxy? Let me know in the comments below, and remember to subscribe for more interesting videos to come. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video.